thank you for joining us to celebrate the accomplishments of our remarkable young professionals. I'm Mike Conway, co-founder of Stacks+Joules. The mission of Stacks+Joules is to bridge the technology opportunity gap through specialized training in computer programming, lighting controls, HVAC, and advanced system integration, all towards careers in the building automation industry. This mission is driven by the proposition that the talent we need as a society to address our most difficult and pressing challenges is abundant. However, it is often overlooked and underappreciated in low-income, diverse communities. We're about to be presented with factual evidence, and we're about to experience affirmation of this core principle of abundant talent through our young professionals and their industry mentors. Stacks+Joules honors the talent and genius of our diverse young youth by supporting them in mastering the highest level cutting-edge technologies. These are hugely valuable technologies. They drive the health of indoor air quality, that they're essential to reducing energy to address climate change, and they more broadly are really central to all automated systems. As they master these complex technologies, our graduates elevate themselves into positions of eminence at the very outset of their professional lives. And that is certainly something to celebrate. So, in my admittedly California way, I invite you to open yourself to the marvel of their excellence. Thanks again and enjoy. And now I'll pass it over to someone I've been enjoying life with ever since we met in Mrs. Davidson's second grade class, John Spooner.
John Spooner. I'm the other co-founder of Stacks+Joules, and I gotta let you know, we are super excited for our new cohorts this year as we prepare the next generation of building automation specialists to address the air handling challenges of a post-COVID New York City. This year, we're gonna stick with our fully virtualized curriculum, training 75 students across four cohorts. We'll again be at the UA Maker Academy, the Lower Eastside Girls Club with students from City of School, and our newest cohort at the Eastside Community School. Now, one of the innovations that we bring to students are things like this tech pack. Now, these are outfitted to each student and contain a fully wireless lighting control kit, as well as energy management measurement devices. Now, specifically around this light kit, which is open source, and we actually developed in partnership with MIT, these bulbs are addressed using Python, and they are able to wirelessly control and program these and access a rainbow of colors. Now, you would think sending such high-tech devices home would strictly be sent home so that they could hone their technical skills, but in fact, they offer something deeper. They actually create community across the digital divide. By sending out this unfamiliar technology, our students are rushing to try to understand it, and what actually happens is an ad hoc network of support crops up with all the students sharing their insights. This way, they're able to get the classroom experience brought into their home through their screen. These types of innovations need your support. And Stacks+Joules, our mission is supporting these children and conferring with industry to make sure that the skills we're training are relevant to the workforce future. Now, if you're able to support us at the $250 level, we can buy one of these light kits for a student. And if you're able to inch up further to the $1,000 level, we can outfit them with an entire tech pack. Of course, we're open to larger donation amounts, and we would gladly have a discussion about how your larger donation could help us expand our mission. Now, I want to thank everyone for being here on a Friday night, and let's get ready for an awesome event. All right, thanks again. Stacks+Joules.
Bridging the tech opportunity gap with a specialized curriculum in computer programming for building automation controls.
Mentors. My name is Fran. I am a 20 years old Hispanic woman. I was born in Mexico and migrated to the U.S. at the age of 2. I am an alumni from Stacks+Joules. Today we will be giving you an insight on what Stacks+Joules is about. We will be seeing and experiencing firsthand interactions with our students and trainees. And today with me I have...
Hi, my name is Olivia. I'm from the Lower Eastside. I'm 18 years old. I'm mixed with black and white. I'm an alumni of Stacks+Joules, and being a part of Stacks+Joules was totally awesome. And now let's listen to Wendy and Robbie discuss some of the awesomeness.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for taking part in our virtual celebration. My name is Wendy, and I'm joined with Robbie by RAB Lighting.
Yeah. Thanks, Wendy. Thanks for the introduction. Just wanted to give people a little bit of background to myself. As Wendy mentioned, my name is Robbie Parikh. I work for RAB Lighting. In my free time, my family and I love and dearly miss music. So since that is not an option these days, live music, I should say, since that's not an option these days, you know, we spend a lot of time outside, hiking, swimming, gardening, and just enjoying the sunshine while we can before the snow falls. And now what about you, Wendy? Tell me a little bit about yourself, or tell everyone about yourself.
My name is Wendy Sierra. I'm class of 2020. I've been with Stacks+Joules for a year now. I like to draw. Before this whole pandemic happened, I would play softball.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. And I like to spend time with my family.
Yeah, great. Family's number one, that's for sure.
Yes.
So, Wendy, tell me a little bit about your experience with Stacks+Joules, and what is one of the highlights that you've had through the program so far?
I have many.
Okay, cool.
In this internship was presenting a proposal on my school lighting picture with RAB. It was also really great creating and presenting my own audit. I remember going on a trip with RAB and learning about their LED lighting and controls. I also remember doing hands-on with Taurus Tech, and over the summer working with Niagara 4 and meeting new people from the same pathway.
Awesome. Awesome.
What about you, Robbie? Tell us about your highlights in being a mentor. Or
yeah, so I mean, you guys are doing both the lighting and the HVAC side. So, you know, for me on the lighting side, it's to your point, that lighting presentation that you and your colleagues did, I thought was definitely the highlight for me so far over the last few years. Being able to walk the school, do that audit, like you said, and then see you guys get more and more comfortable with what you're presenting to that audience. And I think we had 30 people attend that presentation, something like that. And then the conversation didn't end there, right? You inspired myself and Stacks and Joules and organizations like UA Maker itself, the folks at NYSERDA, to really figure out how we can make this, continue this conversation and bring something really tangible to our schools. And that all really started with you and the students at Stacks and Joules. So seeing that from beginning to end, and knowing that that's really not the end, that we're continuing to take your message forward, was really, really exciting for me.
Okay.
I guess my question for you, specific to that lighting presentation, what did you find valuable about that presentation? But more importantly, what did you find that was fun about that presentation?
Being able to present a big project was really fun. And it brings a lot of memories back to it when I talk about it. Getting out of my comfort zone is one of the fun things that happened because I'm a very shy person. And being able to showcase my progress in an establishing way, since it was my first time doing a presentation in front of a lot of people that can make a change.
Awesome. Awesome.
Thank you for your time, Robbie, and everyone attending. We look forward to things to come and hope you can join us in this program. Your help does make a difference.
Hello, my name is Samaya Sultana and I attend the Urban Assembly Maker Academy. In our school, we have two pathways you can choose, which is digital media and computer science. I chose computer science, which led me to an opportunity to work in Stacks and Joules, and here's one of my mentors.
Hi, I'm Tom Quinn, and I'm a business mentor for Stacks and Joules. I come out of the industry, the building management industry, and that's one of the things we're trying to do is prepare the students for entry into that business model. So we started out the year in class as a internship project, and could you tell us a little bit about how we started with the beginning of Stacks and Joules and where we ended up through the process?
Yeah, so in the beginning, we worked mostly on like Python and like programming with light shows, so we worked with like light bulbs and things like that. But later we realized that the lighting system in our school was not the best and it needed some fixing. So we wanted to create a proposal. RAB helped us with that by helping us doing a lighting audit. And then they sent in a plan that would help us have a system that was more efficient, like, you know, more cheaper and would actually produce less carbon. So we had that whole proposal and we did a presentation at Civic Hall with a lot of politicians, people from the DOE, a lot of government officials. And after that, we also got to do hands-on training in HVAC, where we got to work with refrigerants, plumbings, and like we did so much like hands-on training. But due to that, during that time, COVID hit, and I took a break during that time, and I moved on to something else called Global Youth Village. And in this program, I was in a group called United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. So we worked a lot with like the UN goals, and the one I chose was climate change, which kind of relates to Stacks and Joules because we were working on being sustainable and producing less carbon emissions. So this program kind of touched me personally since we got to create projects trying to reduce carbon emissions. And after that, we got to resume back to Stacks and Joules, and we worked on Niagara 4, and I noticed that the hands-on training with HVAC related a lot to Niagara 4. So working online, even though we couldn't see each other in person, was still manageable, and we still did it as a team just because from before we were always a team, and we were able to just continue what we started.
Now, you had other people that joined in that weren't from your class originally on that project, right?
Yeah. So even with them in the beginning, like we hadn't spoke much, but once you're in like teams and doing a project that has a purpose towards it, we all really start connecting and just working together really well.
So the fact that you were applying what you knew was important, that everybody got together and worked on that.
Yeah.
Great.
Talking with Lori Safdie, who's a graduate of the Stacks+Joules program and is attending Mount Holyoke studying political science and environmental law.
Hi, and this is Anne Marie. She has been working at NORESCO for over 13 years in the measurement and verification department. She's also the manager of Engineering Technical Solution Group, and she provides programming and analysis for all groups and have created databases, applications, analytical tools. Additionally, she works for the M&V group with their control projects. It's Anne-Marie and I am Lori.
So you're interested in policy and environmental law. And how did Stacks+Joules program help kind of bring that about? Or did you think about it before?
Well, I started Stacks+Joules program and I honestly did not think that it would like at all help me with what I wanted to be in the future. I just thought it would be a cool and interesting thing to do at the time. But now thinking back on it, I learned a lot about HVAC and lighting and how all that works and how you can design things to save more energy. And that will definitely help me in the future, I think, when I do want to go into politics and help make laws and policies to help the environment, because I'm very interested in trying to save the environment. And knowing the backgrounds of all that will definitely help me in the future.
Right, it will.
Yeah, help me like know like what's going on in the back, so it'll help me like make better laws and policies and understand what's happening.
Right, and you'll know based on what you've learned about the lighting and how even just changing, like at home, even just changing light bulbs can make a big difference. But in a school setting or a university, what a big difference it is going from one fixture to another or to LED lighting. Yeah. And so companies, we look into what the savings can be and also what the benefits to the environment, whether it's solar or just internal lighting or upgrading the HVAC system, different things like that, and working with government regulations, and also with things like rebates when they offer incentives so that schools and other projects are able to do more to make sure that their choices and upgrades are beneficial to everyone.
Yeah, definitely. That's really important. Also, like something that like was really interesting to me was how how in depth it all is, like with HVAC systems. And when we were doing our Niagara planning, like it was crazy how everything kind of leads to something. And if you do one thing wrong, the whole thing could go bizarre.
Right.
You need to make sure that you're tracking every step and doing every step correctly. And then you also need to be able to go back and look and be like, okay, I did this correct, but I did this wrong. That's why that's not working. So you have to be able to retrace your steps.
Yep. And probably once you got into like the Niagara module and after a few days or after a week, it probably didn't seem as overwhelming or frightening as that first day when you're like, how am I going to figure this out?
Definitely. I was very overwhelmed on the first day, but then once we like were starting to work on it, it slowly made sense and all the pieces fit together. And like I understood how to use it, which was like crazy. Because in the beginning, I was like, "What are all these buttons? And what does all this do?" You know. But now it's just like I understand it much better.
Right. And then everyone's presentations, even when you had a bump, like when things didn't work right, everyone just rolled with it. It was really amazing. Sometimes people in the field are like, "Oh, this doesn't work. I'm just going to stop." But you all just jumped right in and kept going.
Yeah. It was also really cool to see, like, there are, like, so many programs like Niagara that work like that. So it was cool to see how, like, when other people use different programs, it was, like, it was all the same, you know, in a way. Where it's, like...
Yeah, it all has the same foundation.
Yeah, like, I was able to recognize, like, what we did in Niagara in other people's work.
Yeah. Like, some of the things Leslie had, the diagrams where you could say, oh, that's exactly what we did.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely. Thank you for having this conversation with me, Anne-Marie.
Thank you. Thanks for letting us participate. It's been probably more exciting for us than the students.
Have a good day.
You too.
Bye. Thank you so much, Lori and Anne-Marie Xavier. Also, Wendy and Ravi, for sharing such great information with us. Don't you agree, Olivia?
Yeah, I definitely miss live music too, Robbie and Wendy. That was a great throwback to our first project with Python coding for the lighting show. That made me feel like a real hacker, not gonna lie.
Most definitely. Yeah, the project really gave us a great start. I remember working on my lighting controls project with Lori, actually, who we just saw discuss her time at Stacks+Joules with Anne-Marie Xavier from NORESCO.
Yeah, I feel a lot better about the future knowing that Lori is going to be fighting towards climate change with policy. Like,
right. It was so cool to hear how she applied what she learned about energy sustainability with Stacks+Joules to her own passion of policy towards climate change.
Yeah, it shows how the work we did this year with Stacks+Joules can be applied to a diverse set of interests and not only just building and tech automations, you know, like, just like Maria, who's definitely interested in the medical field.
Most definitely. Now let's listen as Maria discusses how she was impacted by Derek Otiano from Tridium. We will also hear from Anne-Marie Bola and Olivia.
Hello, Maria. Do you mind introducing yourself?
Of course. Hello, my name is Maria Moreno. I attend UA Maker Academy and I am an intern at the Stacks+Joules program. Now, Mr. Otiano, would you mind doing the same and introducing yourself?
I'm happy to. My name is Derek Otiano. I'm one of the senior Niagara trainers at Tridium. Maria.
It's okay. It's casual.
Share with us how the Niagara training at Stacks+Joules affected you and your confidence.
Okay. So I would say it has affected my confidence in two ways, because it has taught me to take on a positive outlook about new work that I go into. To be honest, in the beginning, I would say that I underestimated the work I was doing a bit because I didn't understand the significance or the importance in the bigger picture in the real world. But as I dove deeper, as I acquired more hands-on experience, I was able to realize the real world implications of Niagara in places around the world, in buildings and automation in general. And as for my personal confidence, I would say that I learned an important lesson, which is to let time do its job, take effect, because I'm a very eager person when it comes to learning, and I just wanted to learn everything right away, but I realized that I had to take it step by step, part by part, bit by bit, and that the information would unfold itself. So basically, I gained confidence in the learning process.
Excellent. Well, Maria, can you share with us some of the specific technical skills that you picked up or that you were exposed to?
Yes. So on Workbench, we learned a lot of new technical skills. So just some examples would be graphics, calendars, schedules. To be specific, we were able to produce like simulations of weekly schedules, holidays, and going off of simulations, we were able to create semi-complex simulations of what real-life automation in areas such as boiling control and hot water pumps would look like. So that was very interesting because we got to basically take components and put them together and see what the setup would look like. Components such as numeric writable and Boolean writable. So yeah, we did learn a lot of technical skills. Now, Mr. Otieno, I would like to ask you a question. How is this important to you and to your company?
Maria, that's a very good question. Just to keep a rein on me, I have prepared bullet points, so okay, I'll refer to them from time to time.
Okay.
So number one, one of Tridium's goals is to educate and enlarge the Niagara community, basically educate Niagara community mm-hmm. On the latest and greatest from Niagara. Mm-hmm. And partnering with Stacks+Joules gave us the opportunity to extend that objective. Second, providing resources to students such as Stacks+Joules students allows the Tridium training department to provide or produce training material that reaches a diverse audience. Mm-hmm. And then third, Tridium is invested in training the next generation, basically young people, mm-hmm. To replace older people, such as me.
Okay. Handing the torch.
There you go, handing the baton, as it were. And doing so also affords or extends these students opportunities for work during the summer or even during the school year. Mm-hmm. So we are very excited about that. And then last point, and this is more specific to me, I enjoyed interacting with Stacks+Joules students such as you, Maria.
Thank you.
The questions that you guys were asking showed such energy, and also the opportunity to watch another subject matter expert in the industry using our Niagara framework. That was very exhilarating. So thank you very much for that opportunity.
Well, that's wonderful. Thank you for all of that. So thank you again for taking your time to do this discussion with me. And we appreciate the work you've been doing with us.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you, Maria.
All right. Thank you.
We want to give a big thank you to the Girls Club of Lower East Side
for giving us an amazing place to learn in. We couldn't have done it without you guys.
Thank you. The CEO of Enhanced Building Solutions. And Emery, what made you get involved and dedicate time to work with the interns at Stacks+Joules?
Thank you for asking, Olivia. Stacks+Joules presented at a startup event and shared how they were focused on high school minority groups, such as women and people of color, into the tech industry. I was very excited to hear that their curriculum focuses on learning building automation, coding, HVAC, and obtaining relevant certifications that would provide immediate internships. I see how the trades is being diminished, and knowing that there was an interest in the building industry and that the students would be able to get a jump start on their careers without an enormous amount of debt, I was excited to get involved.
Yeah, all the interns and myself really appreciate that you got involved with our training. It was vital to our success to have you join because you were our first guest on our Zoom call with the all-girls City As group of interns at Stacks+Joules before we merged with UA Maker in the summer. Also this year, due to the pandemic, we had to go remote with learning. And because Enhanced Building Solutions is a training and consulting company within the building industry, creating customized training content, you were prepared to help us adapt to the online learning, you know, experience. You heard we were going over the different parts of the refrigeration unit, and you came in with a great presentation covering everything that we were struggling with and shared your own story as a woman of color from the Bronx in this industry, which really connected to a lot of us at Stacks+Joules. And I still reference my notes, I reference my notes from that presentation so much, especially when preparing to get my EPA. And from then, I've gotten so many great opportunities and certifications. I earned my EPA lighting controls certificate and Niagara 4 license and training. And I feel confident with my work in technology enough to believe I can find a place to make change in the world with the experiences I was given. And I'm looking forward to more opportunities and to expand my knowledge with building automations because of you know, you getting involved with Stacks and Joules and being involved with this great community, great support system, students, and Mike and John. And so I'm thankful for everything that it's brought me, like the privilege of being joined by you and all these other companies involved in 2020. It was great talking with you, and thanks for joining our virtual benefit.
Thank you, Maria and Derek and Anna Marie and Olivia. That was so good. Definitely passing the torch and guidance to the future generation. Don't you agree, Olivia?
Thank you, Fran. And gosh, you said it perfectly. Like, you can definitely see the genuine passion to change the future in this industry that the conversation that I had with Anne Marie held, and also the conversation that Marie and Derek had.
Definitely. And I know you had a blast talking with Anna Marie. Definitely a recap of our journey in Stacks and Joules.
Hey, Stacks and Joules students. My name is Felix Ramos. I am a system specialist for Alberio Energy, and I am also a Stacks and Joules alumni. Now, right now, I am located in the shop within our office where I've been doing a bit of panel building for the past couple of weeks. And what panel building consists of is, you know, putting multiple parts together for the electricians to be able to connect their devices into. These panels usually consist of circuit breakers, terminals, terminal blocks, grounds, and transformers. Now, just wanted to give a quick thank you to Mike and John. Thank you guys very much for giving me this opportunity to be here. I would not have been in this position if it wasn't for you guys. So I just wanted to say thank you. I appreciate all of this, and I hope you students have a wonderful day. Thank you.
Hey, Stacks and Joules, this is Gavin Dollars, and I'm on the job right now.
Hello, everyone. My name is Samalise Rodriguez. I'm joined by Luke Bauer. Luke is the principal of the UA Maker Academy in New York City and has been a teacher and administrator since 2002. He comes from the great state of Kansas.
Yes, hello, and thank you very much. I'm joined by Samalise Rodriguez, Program Manager for Small Business and Diversity at NORESCO. She works to assure greater inclusion across the company for women, people of color, and other underrepresented groups. Samalise is from Massachusetts.
Workforce diversity is important to a company's success. The American labor force is changing. The current workforce is aging out. Our demographics are shifting too. Soon we will have a majority minority population, and for the first time in the US, women now surpass men. Companies are seeking out a more diverse workforce and are exploring ways to tap into younger, more diverse talent pools, especially in the STEM fields.
Here at the Urban Assembly Maker Academy, our partnership with Stacks and Joules has opened up a wealth of opportunities for our students. UA Maker students come from all five boroughs of New York City and represent the diversity of our great city. Over 70% of our students qualify for free and reduced lunch. Our student body is comprised of 45% Latinx, 35% Black, 10% Asian, and 10% white. I'm honored to be the principal of the Urban Assembly Maker Academy, which is working to support diversifying the workforce.
And our industry sees your students and needs them. Younger workers have the advantage of being tech forward, which shortens the learning curve with new technology. And technology is now integrated into the building sciences more than ever. The energy industry has many career opportunities that can be a perfect match for students with a variety of skills. The COVID pandemic revealed the importance of controlled indoor environment to the spread of disease. We're seeing more and more clients making energy efficiency upgrades to building systems, often paired with automated features to help maintain healthy spaces for people to work and live in.
Here at Maker, as a CTE school, we specialize in digital media and computer science. We know that students engage in school more strongly when they get to work with and interact with employers, industry partners, and nonprofits. When they know what they're learning in school is applicable to their lives both during and after graduation. The Stacks+Joules program teaches students concepts in computer science that are applicable to building automation and HVAC systems. And by partnering with professionals like yourself and other mentors at NORESCO, the students get to apply their skills at the highest levels.
We can help illuminate the pathways into the energy efficiency and sustainability industry through offerings such as mentoring, internship opportunities, and targeted partnerships with schools and nonprofits like UA Maker and Stacks+Joules that provide career and STEM education to a diverse student body.
Well, you're definitely doing just that, and we can see the positive impacts on our students. In fact, we are super proud as this summer our first graduate was hired full-time into the energy industry workforce.
Well, that's great, Luke, and congratulations. Thank you so much for your time today.
Yes, thank you, Sam Elise, and thanks for all you're doing and for joining us
thank
today.
Thank you all for coming and being part of a wonderful evening and experiencing the magic that happens at Stacks+Joules. I hope you enjoy the rest of your evening and don't forget to donate at stacksandjoules.org/benefit2020. Thank you, everyone. It's been real. Peace out.